you and I want to hide all our Facebook posts, I don't blame you. How do you set all your Facebook posts, photos and videos to private or have a privacy of only me without deleting all our posts or our Facebook accounts? Or maybe you do want to bulk delete your Facebook posts. I know exactly the position you're in because I'm in that position now. I don't know why I'm holding on to this stuff. And I don't know why I've been putting it off for so long. I do know that people's tweets and Facebook posts have been held against them. There are high profile cases where people have lost their jobs for things that they've said online, things they've posted on Facebook like 10, 15 years ago, and it's being held against them now. I don't stand by anything I've written, least of all on Facebook. I'm a comedy writer and I've been trying stuff out online for about 15, 20 years. I've posted things that are deliberately wrong just to see if they were funny. I don't stand by any of it. And I sure as Facebook do not want any of that to be held against me 15 years after I've put it out there. I am going to bulk remove all my Facebook posts. I'm going to set them all to private, or as Facebook calls it, only me. And I'm going to be doing this in real time, step by step, so that you can see the process every step along the way. You can jump ahead in this video right now to start deleting, but I'm going to first back up and download everything that Facebook has on me, all my Facebook posts, photos and videos. I want to store them so at least I have a copy of them. And I'm hoping that if I then delete everything, I've already done what I need to do to keep my stuff. So first you need to click on your face, your avatar, on the top right hand corner of your Facebook homepage. And then we're going to go down to settings and privacy. And then we're going to click on settings. Over on the left hand side, there's this column here of all the different options. We're going to click on your Facebook information. And that brings up this page. And you can see from some of the options here, down here, for instance, you can deactivate and delete your account. I don't know why, I think I need to still be in Facebook just to check what's being said about me and to check where I'm being tagged. So all of this, staying with Facebook, is from a place of mistrust. But this is the menu that we need, and we're going to go into download your information. And that brings up this downloads page. You can pause the video here just to see about the different options. Basically, you've got two choices. You can either download an HTML file, which is like a web page. It's gonna look like a web page when you open it, once you've downloaded it. The other option is JSON, a JSON file. And that is a file that you could take to another social network and upload it there. So it's to enable portability of your data. I don't wanna repeat the mistakes of my Facebook page. And you've got some options with media quality. We're going to keep that high. And you can also select a date range if you just wanted to download particular years. I'm going to download everything, so I've got everything in one place. Scrolling down to the next section, you can select the information that you want to download. So this is the list here, things that you've saved, your messages, posts, all your pages and profiles. I'm just basically gonna see how I have time sucked, how I've wasted my life on Facebook. So I'm looking forward to this, plus all the other information that Facebook, or Meta, as they like to call themselves now, as they distance themselves from their appalling behavior over the last decade. Now, I don't know why, but request a download hasn't appeared here. So the button's here, but I can't click on it. It says you need to select a date range. All right, so we'll choose all time. So now the button has appeared, big blue button, request a download. I've no idea how long this is going to take, so let's do a time jump. Whoa, it's 17 minutes later and I've got this email from Facebook. It's 17 minutes. The file you've requested containing your Facebook information is now ready for you to download. Yes. So it took 17 minutes and I'm dressed differently because I'm doing this the next day, because I did not think it was going to be that quick. I am now going to click on this available files link, and that opens up the download your information page. In the top right hand corner, we have a tab here, available files, instead of the request a download tab. And there is one download here ready for me to download. There's a little option here for delete, so you can get rid of it when you don't need it, but I'm gonna hit download and I'm gonna download this file. And while that's downloading, we will get to deleting and setting all our Facebook posts to private, promise you. But let me show you what's in this download of all your information from Facebook. And it comes as a zip file, so I will open with the unzip thingy. Let's see what's in this folder. there are a really impressive 46 folders. Look at all these things, all these different types of Facebook data. The one I want to go to first is posts. Let's dip into a couple of these. So there's an album and a media folder. Oh, so many folders. But they're all presented in HTML, which means that if I double click on them, like this one, let's go to album 6. It presents your posts as a familiar web page, which is kind of cool. So these are some of my many photos. But outside of those folders, we have your posts. This is my very first post, October the 29th, 2007. I'm eating stuff in Borough Market. I mean, it's quite literally my life flying before my eyes. I mean, I'm glad that I've got them all on my drive here. You know, really great stuff, like me with the famous UK presenter, Gok Wan. You can see me there nestled behind the camera, confidently producing this shoot. Here's me with broadcasting legend Danny Baker on my very first job in television as a runner. I was such a professional. Look, this is me at work here, knocking tea over every keyboard I ever worked with. But now I want to set all of my posts to private, and I'll show you how to delete them as well. First, we click on your avatar in the top right hand corner, and we'll go to settings and privacy. And then we're going to go down to activity log, and that opens up the activity log page. In the activity log on the left hand side, you'll see right at the top your posts, and I'm going to click on this pull down menu, and it brings up your posts as a page. So this here is literally everything I've ever posted. When you scroll down to the bottom, it stops and it reloads more posts and photos. So let's speed this up. This is me scrolling down to the very bottom of everything I've ever done on Facebook. So this process takes me about 5 minutes. It might take you longer, but oh my goodness, there's so much junk here. The next thing we can do is to scroll back up again, right to the top. And when you get to the top, if you click on one of these tick boxes here, or check boxes, let's just tick the first one to show you what happens. All of these buttons come to life. So we have deselect, that obviously deselects the tick. There's this archive button here. I cannot see the point of the archive button. It just puts it into an archive folder. The next button along is the big bad trash can. I'm so tempted to do this. Let's see what happens. I've selected a few of my posts. When you hit trash, it brings up this dialogue. Move to trash. Items moved to trash will be deleted after 30 days. Wouldn't it be great to just to delete everything? I won't do that just yet. I'm going to use this button here, change audience. So I'm going to hit the all box. And if I tick this box, it selects all of my posts. And you can see here, this number has gone up to 1,762. That's how many posts I've put on Facebook in my life. I'd love to know how many you've made. Leave a comment down below and hit a thumbs up if you've reached this point, because I'd love to know if anyone is going through with this. I am so excited that you and I get to do this. We can now set all of our Facebook posts, photos, videos, everything to private or only me by clicking on this button here, change audience, and it brings up this menu. You can select the audience, you can select public and set everything to public. I don't wanna do that. Friends, which I've already done. This is the one I want. I'm going to select only me for all of my posts. And all I need to do now is to click on this confirm button. That's making sure that you're sure about this. All of the selected posts will have their audience changed. So obviously, if you have lots of posts with different types of audiences and custom audiences, it's just going to wipe them all and set them to only me. I'm going to hit the change button. Do it, do it. Oh, what? Something went wrong. Facebook. Naughty. Let's try again then. Change audience. Only me. Confirm. Something went wrong. Facebook, you utter rotter. Right, this is one of the many reasons we've got to leave Facebook. What I'm trying now is I'll go into date. I'm going to filter out, say, 2019. Save changes. There, those are all my posts from 2019. So you can hear some randy pigeons up above. Then I'm going to select all. So that's 108 posts. And I'm going to hit change audience. Only me. Confirm. Change. Yes, it's worked. Okay, so that's 1 year, one of the 14 years. I'm gonna now have to go through every single year and set every year to only me. I'm sorry, if I can find a quicker way, I'll put it in the description below, but Facebook is not being nice. Who'd have thought? I know, I've been spending far too long on this, I know. But it's nearly over, Casper, it's nearly over. So, I mean, I should just delete my Facebook account, shouldn't I? Or at least delete all the posts. But right here is another video that YouTube thinks that you will love. Good luck with your Facebook deleting.